with the detailing they had, we saw many good work, but they were lucky enough that no one else came and started it before them. Because the total capex to get to something like this is not much.
Okay, any
one last one? Well said. The time to market versus the ability to what is required to be in terms of time. So, one final comment from me on this case.
Okay. I just wanted to comment. Well, surely, I mean, having a mentor who was negative on them could have frustrated them. I'm sure it must have frustrated them. But that's what maybe allowed them to turn inward and go through a very thorough process of evaluation of what really the
that's market. The way to look
so,
at it.
You know, like make their attempt more and more thorough, more and more painstaking. What I would be really interested in knowing was maybe just, you know, four or five of them having jobs, not too many finances. How did they go about doing these market evaluations? Because market evaluation costs money. Taking surveys costs money. So what tools did they use? How did they do all of this survey in a low cost manner? I think that really must have been like, you know, a very innovative approach to them. It must have required a very innovative approach. So maybe if you could share with me, you know, the case study source, and maybe if it talks about, you know, how they went about doing this.
There's a book, you know, you can go through the internet. Case study is available.
Because I think that that's where they really won the war, is assessing the market without spending too much money.
See, as Madhubai in the opening side mentioned, that try to not take this as a story or something, try to relate it to your industry and where, you know, it resembles what you are doing or it doesn't resemble what you are doing.
I think, you know, the details of the building blocks which would be available in the detailed case study, you have to pick up from it. Learn what is important and what is relevant for you. But for that you need to have, you know, the time taken out and read carefully the detail and pick up the building blocks at various stages. You know, what are the challenges they face and what kind of challenges can be related to your area of business which, you know, you want to expand or you want to plug into. So that's very important. Yeah. And there will be, I'm sure, a lot of narratives in the building.
Okay. Two very quick comments. One, as far as the case is concerned, and do it with only one. As far as the case is concerned, the case study method is that different people will draw different lessons out of it, as it is according to their reality. One, and the other aspect of it is that one should not really. Man is a very rational man and woman. And therefore, we try to look for arguments to justify what we can. Case study is not a good thing. Just because they succeeded in certain things, we can't really say that as a way to go forward. So, that's just a caution.
And the other case we wanted to take up is one is a success story and one is a failure story. So, maybe we get a different version. Now, does how many of you know about Segway? All of you? So you know how, what it is all about?
Only few of them are aware, but you say in few narratives what Segway meant, if you can say that. Or if it is coming out in this, that's fine.
Well, I think everybody needs to know. Mr. D. Cameron received the highest honor for invention and many patents to his credit. And he successfully designed the iBot, you know, the wheelchair which can climb stairs, and he's a very innovative guy with many patents to his credit, and he invented Segway. Recognizing broader applications for the technology, he brought a team of people to help him with the Segway idea. The goal was to build a safe, efficient vehicle that would prevent pollution and help individuals navigate congested cities. So nowadays, you know, in India especially, is very, very relevant. There's so much congestion. There is a need to do something better to reduce the pollution and make it safe for people to travel. Steve Jobs.
Most impressive credentials.
Yeah.
Most impressive credentials. Three of the best companies he has invested.
Everybody knows Steve Jobs. He was prepared to invest 63 million to get 10% of the company. The Amazon founder Jeff Bezos, he opined that Segway would have no problem selling at all. Unlike the other case where Adam says that no, this is not sellable. This guy says, don't worry, jump into it. And this, and then John Doerr, who invested in Google, he pumped in $80 million. He said this is a brilliant idea and it's going to be a runaway success. With the remark that this will be the fastest company in the world to reach $1 billion sale. So this is the background. In the previous case, there was a negativity, and in this case, there is outstanding positivity. But what happened? The same personal transporter was publicly unveiled on Good Morning America in December 2001 with early units priced around $5,000. They priced the Segway at $5,000, which is quite pricey. But if you look at it this way, you know, it's like just a decent old car in the US. When a rider steps on, for those who don't know about Segway, onboard computers, sensors, and motors keep it upright. So it's a very innovative concept. You might have seen this, you know, at airports and at many places. The two wheels, you know, people travel. Akshay Kumar is there in the film. So I think that way you might relate it. The rider commands the scooter by shifting his weight forward and backward to move it, and then steers by pushing left and right. It works beautifully, and the technology is very impressive. No pollution, cost effective, everything is right, there is nothing wrong. Experiences. The Segway worked as advertised, but it was awkward to use. Why it was awkward? It was small. Instead of building, you could move around here and there, but at 100 pounds, that is almost like 50 kilos, it was too heavy to, if there is any step or something, then you get into big trouble. It can only work on a very flat surface. So it also required the rider to be then guard. And, you know, like Akshay Kumar said, you know, you have to be a hero. What happened with using this Segway? Steve Jobs had already warned Cameron that, you know, Segway's image will be severely tarnished, you know, if there is any accident which happens and somebody is hurt. Because this is a new concept, it has to go. If everything is positive, it will fly. But if there is anything which people get hurt, it can be a big disaster. Three high profile incidents soon followed. In 2003, President George W. Bush, he fell down in his vacation home and unfortunately for Cayman, this was completely filmed by the photographers and the press, and that was there everywhere in the news. And that was a big blow to the Segway. The other one was a British journalist, Piers Morgan. He broke three ribs after he fell off the Segway in 2007. And the worst was the owner, Mr. James, he was killed after he accidentally steered his scooter off the 30-foot cliff. That was the biggest disaster for this. Some of the issues, you know, it's not that it didn't work, it did work very well, but it was envisioned as a way for people to get home from work or vice versa in urban areas. And it was a technological marvel with no pollution, no noise, nothing. It's very beautiful. You can maintain the balance better than a human, and it's fuel efficient, and there was no point, a car, if you go to the office with a car, there's a problem, especially in USA, where to park it. Even if you get a parking space, it's $20, $30, it's very, very expensive. This had a very good, easy option. The problems that sank the Segway weren't technological, they were social. Now what did one person say? When I first bought it was so much fun, says P.T. Peter Shankman, one of the first five people in New York City to buy. But the police didn't know what to do. They said, what is this? There were regulatory issues, they could not accept it. The city could not accept it because, you know, the payments, like Shankman says, that on one block if you go to do on the left side and then the other one you say on the right side, so it was so difficult for him to move, although it was very convenient. Sometimes he was told that he couldn't use it at all. So what to do with the segment? As a personal transport of the segment was a near complete trip. Unfortunately, it doesn't make sense. It is expensive, it is safe, it is heavy, difficult to handle. But he found a measure of success in industrial and fleet application. You imagine a factory where there are a lot of heavy things moved from one place to the other place. And if you have a Segway, it's very easy for the guy to move around and make it very efficient. So, industrial applications, fantastic, very good. But police departments, they had their own version. But and the tour groups, the warehouse workers, the mall security guards, the airport maintenance staff, we see them in the airport many times. They have adopted the Segway and it works very well. So, how did Steve Jobs join here and Jeff made a mistake?
Those are the things that unless somebody uses, like people use it and give you feedback here, this product is good. Because I'm sure they want to keep it tightly wrapped because of the patents and you know duplication or whatever, copying of the product or whatever. So they probably didn't go around asking for
very
feedback.
Very valid point, yes. Anybody else? Yes,
Abhishek? Sir, in my opinion, any kind of B2C businesses where we're trying to sell to customers. There are two key points in my opinion. One is we should be able to solve some problem for the customer, or we should be able to satisfy some latent or other kind of need for the customer. Now they did try to do that, but in trying to do that they ended up giving the customers a lot of problem. Like typically it was heavy, and if it's intended as a personal product, if I give the analogy of a computer, the whole idea of a laptop being lighter and smaller is that we solve the problem of carrying it around. So that's why I personally feel that it failed on a personal level in terms of having to market it.
I think we have to see from a strategy point of view where they went wrong. With all the heavyweights behind them, how could the strategy be so
bad? I think one, they took money from Steve Jobs, John Doerr, Jeff Bezos. If you look at all three names, they're all from the tech industry. And people from the tech industry, especially you know the Silicon Valley, they tend to live in a bubble. That's maybe 30 years, 40 years, you know, ahead in the future. They don't really think about what regular life looks like, maybe you know, somewhere in the middle of rural Pennsylvania. So I think sure their opinion, they thought it was really cool. But if you know look at a guy moving around in a Segway on the street, it actually looked quite you know radical, or you could even say it looked very stupid. So you know a regular bicycle looks a lot better than you know riding a Segway. So I think that's where they went wrong in the
mauling on one side. You know, in the previous case we said you have to be original. It was original, but
at the same time it was unnecessary originality in the sense, why would you take a Segway to work when you can as easily
there's less pollution, there's every all merits are there. Yes.
So I think the product is pretty good. I don't think we have questions on the product.
There was nothing wrong technology.
Right. Yeah. But I think they were probably not ready to start selling for a couple of reasons. There's a reason why Amazon, Flipkart, Uber, they've all been successful. And the reason is they have penetrated the market first. Like, they're not worrying about making money today. what I feel is they started, it's a new product altogether and it's priced at $5,000. Like a normal person might not buy it if you can buy a car within the same money. If it was priced at say $1,000 initially, it's okay if the company is making cash losses. But then say in the next 10 years, if they had a vision that every second person on this planet would have a Segway, and then if they raise the price to $5,000, I think then that would have been a better model. I think that's what probably Steve Jobs and all these other two guys were looking at. They probably were not looking at just selling a few of them and making money.
That's a very good question, Avasi. How can three guys get it wrong who are people who have founded companies which are benchmark today? I don't know, nothing could come to mind. I don't know. Possibly this is a disruptive innovation. So in the excitement of it, your lack of detailing somewhere can take a hit. And in this case, it is the last leg where they got it wrong. Everything was perfect. But the last leg of any new product development in auto, you have this vehicle validation where you make a product for a vehicle and you validate it on it to see if it serves that function or not. Here, you go with the goal of safe, efficient, navigated, congested cities, but if you validate the same product by giving 50 of them to users as trials and getting their feedback on whether it actually validates the use or not, you would have got the same feedback. Someone would have fallen, someone would have, you know, so then you can't brand it as safe. So I think that last leg possibly got
safe. Many of you have got very good tools, and I'm very happy that most of you have got the feedback. So we'll just go through what happened. To accurately predict the success of a novel idea, it's best to be a creator in the domain you are judging. In the previous case where you were talking about spectacles, three guys were wearing spectacles, they knew what are the hardships and what are the pain points and everything. And the fourth guy, who was not wearing but he had 5 years' experience in selling glasses. So they had the domain experience. Now these are all techies, as Malik had said. Now this is a social problem. They didn't envisage this stuff. You know, people will not accept it. So they were not in the domain space. That is one thing. Dean Kamen kept his idea secret. So he thought, you know, if I share it, I did, as you very rightly said, you do the test marketing or you do the due diligence or you have a peer review or something, then people will steal the idea and he is lost. So he kept it as secret, but you know, he paid the price for the secret. He did not do enough homework, especially when the group had no transportation experience. None of them had. Domain inexperience, operation, over enthusiasm are the main culprits for this lack of success. It's a huge change of behavior, very high expense and very limited value. You are the wow factor. You know, it's like, wow, I have a Segway. That's it. What's beyond that? Practicality, it's so heavy, you cannot. In India, it's impossible because you know, there are no pavements which are at one level. You just cannot use it. Maybe they can use it in the airport because it's all flat. But it's beyond that, it's not possible. So had the Segway been submitted to the Wobbles idea, you know, in the previous case we had the Wobbles idea where they did the market survey, they did the peer review, they did all kinds of analysis, like what is the price level, like Shonak said, maybe 5,000 was a barrier, you know, people don't want to pay 5,000. But they never checked because they wanted to keep it a secret. So if they have checked, maybe they have found out that, you know, if it is 500, it's okay, maybe 1,000, it's okay, but 5,000, no.